Hello and welcome back to the D-COT disCast. I'm your host Steve and today is Wednesday, June 21st, 2023. And today we're talking about Disney Plus debuting 28 restored classic shorts, CFO Steps Down, Elemental released in theaters, and more. So I'm sorry I missed Monday's disCast. I had a very long, tiring, but a good tiring and enjoyable Father's Day weekend. We stayed club level at Contemporary Resort. It's our first time doing something like that. We love doing, well, first time staying club level at the Contemporary. We love doing these staycations at club level because, well, you get to use the lounge for both days. So let me try to go through our what we ended up doing this weekend as fast as I can here. So we got to the resort at 10 a.m. on Saturday, checked in, and our room was ready, which was awesome because that's pretty early. We dropped our stuff off in the room, which was two doors down from the lounge, super convenient. And breakfast is served from 7 a.m. to 10:30 a.m., so we had about 20 minutes left to enjoy breakfast. After breakfast, we went to the room to get comfortable, put our things away. The weather was unfavorable, but it was clearing up. At 11:30 a.m., snacks are served in the lounge until 4 p.m., so we got some snacks, went back to the room, put our bathing suits on. The sun started breaking out through the clouds, so we went and hung out poolside for a few hours, which was a lot of fun and very relaxing, and got a little red, a little... It was good, though. We got a nice tan. We headed back to the room for dinner, which is served from 5 to 7 p.m., and after that, we took a monorail trip and got off at Magic Kingdom and walked back to the Contemporary. It was a beautiful night. And it's only about a 10-minute walk from the Magic Kingdom to the Contemporary. Sunday, which was Father's Day, I got up before the crew did. I love early mornings because they're quiet and peaceful and it's some me time. Get to spend some time with myself and just enjoy the peace. I got to the club lounge around 6 a.m. to enjoy my book and coffee with the sunrise hitting Magic Kingdom. It made for a beautiful photo, which you can check out on D-COT's social media. Breakfast opens at 7 a.m., so guests know this. They started shuffling in a little bit after that, around like 7:05, 7:10. A little more noise in the club lounge. It started to get crowded around 8 a.m., so I headed back to the room, where the rest of the family woke up around 9 a.m. I requested a late checkout for 12 p.m. and got it, so lottery won. Ka-ching, ka-ching. Always ask for a late checkout, especially if you need it. After breakfast, Kara and I went to the pool for an hour before we had to go back to the room to change and get out of the room because we were checking out. Disney has a Florida resident ticket promotion, which I touched on in a previous disCast. Michelle thought it'd be fun for us as a family to go to Magic Kingdom for the day, so we did it! We got to enjoy a day at Magic Kingdom with the family, and we have not done so since COVID. We got to ride Space Mountain, Peter Pan, Seven Dwarfs Mine Train, Haunted Mansion, got to visit Tom Sawyer's Island, got to go on Pirates of the Caribbean and Tron at night. So this is the first time that the kids were able to go on Tron and they absolutely loved it. We got the first and second row. At the end of the day, it was about a total of 22,000 steps. My legs are still recuperating from this and so are my feet. We went back to the resort to see the fireworks after Tron. We got to view it from the lounge balcony. It's all theme park view. And what is a perfect way to end the weekend. All right, let's go to the Disney news. Disney CFO is stepping down. Christine McCarthy will be stepping down as the Walt Disney Company's chief financial officer and taking a family medical leave of absence. Effective July 1st, Kevin Lansberry, EVP and CFO of Disney Parks, Experiences and Products, will serve as the interim CFO while a thorough search of internal and external candidates is conducted for a permanent replacement. McCarthy will stay on as a strategic advisor after stepping down as CFO on June 30th. Bob Iger said, Christine McCarthy is one of the most admired financial executives in America, and her impact on the Walt Disney Company during 23 years of dedicated service cannot be overstated. She is stepping down from her CFO role as she takes family medical leave, but has graciously offered to move into an advisory position to assist her successor in assuming the duties she has so expertly handled these many years. McCarthy has been with the Walt Disney Company since 2000. In 2015, she was appointed to the CFO position. Her contract was previously set to expire in December of 2022, but it was renewed through 2024. Here's some other executive announcements. Melissa Valiquette, Vice President of Magic Kingdom, will become the VP of Industrial Engineering and Park Operations line of business. Sarah Riles will take Valiquette's place as VP of Magic Kingdom. Riles is currently the VP of Disney's Animal Kingdom. Marianne Smith, VP of Customer Experience, will replace Riles as VP of Disney's Animal Kingdom. and Farron Kelly will replace Smith as the VP of Customer Experience. Keller currently serves as the VP of Disney Sports, which includes ESPN Wild World of Sports, Run Disney, and Disney Water Parks. His replacement has yet to be named. The movie Elemental was released in theaters last Friday. My kids went to see it with their summer camp group. They were not impressed with it, which I was surprised to hear that because the trailers looked interesting. Box office results for the opening weekend were not favorable either. However, Rotten Tomatoes' audience score is a whopping 92%. Maybe Disney just didn't advertise this enough? I don't know. But to celebrate the release of this movie, at Disney California Adventure Park, you can learn to draw Wade and Ember at the Animation Academy during select classes for a limited time. The Elemental director Pete Sohn recently dropped by the Animation Academy to see his pals Wade and Ember be drawn to life. Also at Disney California Adventure Park for a limited time, a new water short highlighting the story and characters from Disney and Pixar's latest film Elemental will be presented ahead of World of Color 1. Speaking of Ember and Wade, you can now purchase your very own Elemental sipper from select locations at both Disneyland Park and Disney California Adventure Park for a limited time. There's also a ton of new merchandise. Head on over to the Disney Parks blog for all of those details. There's a lot of holiday parties coming up. It has been confirmed that Tron Light Cycle Run and Rise of the Resistance will use virtual queues during these parties. So for Tron Light Cycle Run, we're talking about Mickey's Very Merry Christmas Party. And for Rise of the Resistance, we're talking about that Jolly Polly Folly Wally Day celebration. Wait, what's the name of it? Oh, yes, Disney Jollywood Nights. Disney's Vero Beach Resort rooms will be refurbished from October 2023 to late January 2024. For all those Vero Beach fans, DVC members or not, this is great news. I'm looking forward to it. Maybe we'll have to make a trip out next summer to Vero Beach to check it out. If you're traveling to Disneyland, you'll want to know about these two attractions being temporarily closed for refurbs. Toy Story Midway Mania will close for refurbishment on July 17th. The calendar does not currently show a reopening date. Soarin' Around the World will close for refurbishment on July 5th and is expected to reopen on July 15th. Disney Plus will be debuting a collection of 28 newly restored Walt Disney Animation Studios classic shorts starting on Friday, July 7th, featuring such iconic stars as Mickey Mouse, Minnie Mouse, Donald Duck, Goofy, Pluto, Chip, and Dale, and the studio's first star, Oswald the Lucky Rabbit. This year marks the centennial of Walt Disney Animation Studios, which is being honored as part of the ongoing Disney 100 celebration. This next one I shouldn't be talking about, but Walt Disney World posted an open casting call looking for performers to portray Bruno from the animated film Encanto. The listing says the role is for potential future special events, so maybe we'll be seeing Bruno at a Disney World meet and greet someday soon. We'll find out, but we can't talk about Bruno. The all-new show called Rogers the Musical is set to debut at Disney California Adventure on June 30th, 2023. Disney announced yesterday that the new show will use a virtual queue system. This will be available only through the Disneyland app like previous virtual queues. Each day that the musical is performing, the virtual queue will open at 10:30 a.m. for the first two show times of that day and at 2 p.m. for the remaining shows that same day. All right, you silly little listeners, that's it for today's D-COT DisCast. Thanks for joining us, and thanks for listening. We hope you have a remarkable rest of your week, and we look forward to providing you more Disney news and reviews on Friday.
Thank you!
Today I leave you with a track from Tomorrowland's Aria Loop, which was played from 1989 to 2003. This one is called Hidden Pathways.